The census has a big deadline looming to release data from this year's count. The compressed timeline, though, because of the pandemic, is raising the Bureau's risks. Chris Mihm is Managing Director of Strategic Issues at the Government Accountability Office. Chris, welcome. Thanks for coming on the program. You testified to Congress recently about this, and I joked with you a bit before we went on the air. We've shaved our gray beards about covering the census, but you've got 12 areas here as the clock is really ticking down toward the end of the month when census says it will stop collecting data. How are these different than the ones that we've looked at in previous censuses, Chris? A lot of them look the same to me.
Yeah, a lot of them are the same, Francis. The challenge now is that they're the same, but almost on steroids, meaning that the combination of the needing to respond to the COVID-19 national emergency, weather events, both with the hurricanes and the wildfires now out west, and the late design change of the decision to move back the date to when apportionment counts will be provided, has made what has already been a very challenging census even more so. And so getting a complete and accurate count will be very, very difficult for the Census Bureau.
So the design change is one of the themes that I've seen in previous censuses. And as I said, before we went on the air, you've been doing these a lot longer than I've been covering them. But I recall the 2010 census, we had some of these same issues. We had the design changes at the last minute. We had the information technology challenges with mobile devices. At least this time, we don't have mobile devices that are completely different at the end than they were at the beginning. But what is your sense of how the Bureau keeps finding itself with these same risks, census after census?
Yeah, the big challenge as we were discussing before we got on the air, I started working on census issues for the 1990 census, actually the roll-up to the 1990 census, and so have a lot of years invested in making sure that we get a good and accurate census. The big challenge that they face this time around that differs from the past is that these late design changes have come really very, very late. And that is the decision made on August 3rd that rather than go forward with a legislative proposal that would extend the dates in which apportionment counts and redistricting counts could be given, to now revert back to what is the current statutory deadline at the end of December. What that did is it cut a month off of field work. It cut 60 days off of the processing. All of this came late, obviously, in census year, and it's really compressed their timeframes. And that's the big challenge that they face now, on top of, again, all the COVID, all the weather-related events that they have. It's enormously difficult for them.
What do we do at this point? What does census do? What can congressional overseers do? What can other agencies do, if anything, to help census meet these deadlines?
Well, there's a couple of things that we can certainly do, and all of us. I mean, first and foremost is that for those of us that have not filled out the census form, there is still time. So fill out your form, send it in, or even better, go on the internet and use the internet option. And that's one of the great success stories. The internet option did work this time, and tens of millions of people did that. Second, cooperate with the census taker if they come to your house and if you haven't filled out the form. Third is that the Census Bureau needs to make sure that it maintains hiring. In a number of places around the country where it has the highest workload that it's still of houses it needs to follow up upon, those are also the areas in where they're having the biggest staffing shortages. And so it's a real very difficult situation there. And then fourth, we have to make sure that the IT systems that are going to be used to actually process the census data, that the testing is done on those. Those were supposed to be the integration of the 12 systems that are being used for processing was supposed to be completed in June. It's now been kicked back to early October. They literally have no water in the schedule. It has to go right, and that's something that they very closely need to manage. And certainly my colleagues are looking at that very closely, my IT specialist colleagues.
From a customer perspective, Chris, I can confirm your findings about the internet option. I did that as soon as it came. It took me just moments to do, worked exactly as it was supposed to work, the antithesis of what one thinks about among all the IT projects that we've heard about in government over the years. It worked magnificently. What difference does that make, and what lessons can the census start taking now to try to apply to 2030? Because it's not long till they start to think about that.
Yeah, it made a big difference, and I'm one of those people that goes by the philosophy about worry about everything, panic about nothing. And so, but I was worried about that, and we were looking at it very closely. I think that the big lesson learned on that is for the census going forward is to continue to use technology, but make sure that it's well tested. Make sure that you use the pretests that build up to the actual decennial. Make sure that you also have the load capacity that can take census responses during peak periods, and that's something that they did. In fact, they on a couple orders of magnitude above what they actually needed. They were able to, they had the capability of taking in those census forms. That is, I think, when all is said and done, going to be one of the great success stories of this census and of what we hope in the end will be an overall success story. But nevertheless, the IT response option, I think, is really worked out for them. Where they have had other challenges on the IT side and where we're concerned is, again, when things come in very late, and that's a story across all IT projects that I know that you've covered all the time, where things come in late, you don't have the opportunity for testing or full testing, that's where you run the enormous risks.
Chris Mihm, thanks very much for coming on the program. Appreciate your time.
My great pleasure, sir. Thank you.